Sheriff Lopez with the Osceola County Sheriff's Office, thank you all for being here today. I want to start by thanking the members of the grand jury who applied the facts to the law and cleared both deputies of any wrongdoing. It's always tragic when it becomes necessary for law enforcement officers to use deadly force. My thoughts are with the individuals and their families involved with this situation. Hopefully, the decision of the grand jurors will help those affected gain closure and begin the healing process. Because law enforcement officers place themselves in dangerous situations daily, deadly force is sometimes the only way to protect innocent people from harm. Officers train for the unfortunate moment where they are forced to make split-second decisions to save themselves or the life of someone else. An officer who uses deadly force appropriately should never, and I repeat, never, be treated as a criminal. There has been a narrative suggesting that these deputies use force because of a petty theft. That's not accurate, and that's not factual. The grand jury has spoken, and an independent group of citizens have stated that this case is not about a petty theft. The truth is, the deputies used deadly force because their lives were in danger by the driver, who decided to make a bad decision that day. The driver chose to ignore lawful commands and use his vehicle as a deadly weapon to strike the deputies. It's unfortunate that the two deputies who fired their weapons in this case had to wait 20 months to be told that they're rightfully and legally performing their jobs as a deputy sheriff. Hopefully in the future, officer-involved shootings will be investigated and addressed as quickly as possible. I learned last night that the grand jury will be making recommendations in the near future, and we look forward to hearing the recommendations. You know, I inherited this agency 3 years ago. There's a lot of policies that are outdated, a lot of policies that could use improvement, you know, and as we run into these critical situations, that's how we look at them and see how we can improve or let them remain the same in order to benefit our community. In the meantime, we've already implemented changes in reference to the box technique that we used. We won't use it in misdemeanors, we'll use it only in felonies. We're also upgrading additional and requesting additional body cams. It's my intention for all sworn law enforcement members to be equipped with body cameras. I believe body cameras bring transparency and help showcase the good work deputies are doing on a daily basis. In addition, I've made personnel transfers to make sure we're getting a good mix of experience and make sure everybody involved is making good decisions when they're working with critical incidents. And finally, I've ordered a review of our written policies regarding shooting into moving vehicles. Changes to this policy will be finalized. It's my goal to ensure all members of the agency police in a manner that is efficient and safe for the citizens of Osceola County. I'll continue to evaluate best practices moving forward and remain committed to improving upon the great work that my deputies do here in Osceola County. I'm going to say in Spanish. Ustedes están, no lo voy a repetir así tan largo, pero ustedes ya saben que el gran jurado tomó la decisión que los oficiales de nosotros actuaron de una manera apropiada. Cuando se defendieron, cuando el individuo intentó pasarle por encima con el carro y usaron la fuerza necesaria para controlar esa situación. Como yo le dije, desafortunadamente, cuando estos incidentes pasan, nosotros como oficiales no nos levantamos por la mañana a decir, vamos a matar a alguien. Eso no es lo que nosotros no queremos hacer. Pero ustedes como ciudadanos deben de respetar las leyes. Aquí las leyes son fuertes, firmes. Y los oficiales también tienen su vida y su familia. Ellos quieren ir a su casa todos los días. Se les digo, por favor, respeten las leyes. Los ciudadanos del gran jurado son la gente que hicieron la decisión final, revisaron toda la evidencia y decidieron que nuestros oficiales estaban actuando apropiadamente de acuerdo con la ley. Okay, I'll take a question in English. We're working on that right now. We're looking at, that's like an older policy. Like I said, once we get all that worked out, we can actually provide you a copy.
And also the making personnel transfers, what does that mean exactly?
What we do is we move people around because there's different tactic units. And based on that experience, we move other people around, sergeants and lieutenants, so they can also gain experience in different areas of the agency.
Does that include the removal of major widely?
Oh, hold on. Can you wait your turn? Are you with the Sentinel?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to give you a copy of this so you can print it because you never put out the accurate information, okay? So wait your turn and you'll be out of here. All right, can you ask finish another question?
Sheriff, the attorney that has represented these families has been incredibly, you know, criticizing because of this case, saying there was lack of transparency, and wants to review these policies. As we know, the grand jury will be reviewing more of these policies. What are your comments towards that?
Yeah, remember, Nijame is an attorney, and he's working on the civil side of it. A lot of these attorneys are going to profit from deputies being found at fault or negligent. In this case, we were cleared, so it kind of puts his theory and everything into a different direction, and that's how they make their money. As for whatever the grand jury brings back for us to review, like I said, I've already made some changes, and I welcome more changes so we can actually make sure we're working effectively and efficiently for the community. Another question?
Nijame also mentioned that the sheriff's office was under investigation by the Department of Justice. Can you
That is an isolated incident where it has to do with a signature affidavit. Has nothing to do with the shooting, nothing to do with me. We provided all the information to the state attorney. They sat on it for 20 months. Bain stepped in, got some clarity to the situation. We send that to the DOJ, and we've been back and forth with emails. We provided the Department of Justice with everything they need in order to make sure that this comes to a closure soon. One more in English and one in Spanish.
Los cambios de la póliza en aspecto al el tiroteando adentro de un vehículo, estamos revisando eso todo ahora. Cuando tengamos esa póliza finalizada, se la vamos a proveer.
¿Y qué tipo de entrenamiento reciben sus oficiales para evitar casos de exceso de fuerza?
Este entrenamiento, recuerda, cada situación va a ser diferente. Tú no puedes entrenar a un oficial cómo actuar durante una situación. Si alguien le va a pasar por encima un carro, ¿qué puede hacer si no tiene otra avenida de salida? Tiene que usar ciertas fuerzas para que él pueda vivir. So, cada caso va a ser diferente. El entrenamiento que nosotros recibimos es del estado de la Florida, del FDLE, y vamos a seguir porque ahora el gran jurado habló y todos estamos bien actuando de acuerdo a la ley.
¿Cuál es la situación actual de los oficiales? ¿Van a ser reintegrados o no van a ser reintegrados?
No, yo lo reintegré hace un año atrás. Y está haciendo un tremendo trabajo. Cuando el Florida Department of Law Enforcement tomó el caso, revisó, nosotros los pusimos a trabajar, porque yo no puedo estar 20 meses con un oficial, dos supervisores detrás de un escritorio haciendo nada cuando no han cometido un error.
¿Cuál es el mensaje para las familias, de, en este caso de las personas fallecidas y de los heridos? ¿Cuál es el mensaje?
Que por favor eduquen a sus hijos, obedecer la ley. Cuando el oficial te da una orden, cuando ven este uniforme, respeten las leyes para evitar una tragedia. Nosotros estamos aquí porque nos gusta vivir en paz y en tranquilidad. Eso es lo que la gente tiene que enseñarle a sus hijos.
Le decía el mensaje para las familias de la...
Pero eso está bien, eso. Okay, I'm done. Thank you. Appreciate you all here.